Hi, I'm Rosalie, and today I'm going to be reading Madeline in London. In an old house in Paris that was covered with vines lived 12 little sisters. They left the house at half past nine. The smallest one was Madeline. In another old house that stood next door lived Pepto, the son of the Spanish administrator. An administrator doesn't have to pay rent, but he has to move whenever he's sent. He took his family and his hat, then left for England, but the cat. "I'm glad," said the cat. "There goes the bad hat. Let's let him annoy some other kitten at the embassy in Great Britain." The little girls all cried, "Boo-hoo. We'd like to go to London, too." In London, Pepto just picked at his dinner. Soon he grew thin, and then grew thinner. And when he began to look like a stick, his mama said, My, this boy looks sick. I think Pepto is lonely for Madeline and the little girls next door." His papa called Paris. "Hello, Miss Clavel. My name is Pepto. Is at all well? He misses you, and he's lonesome for Madeline and the little girls next door. May we request the pleasure of your company? There's plenty of room here at your embassy. Quick, darlings, pack your bags and we'll get out to the airport and catch the next jet." Fill the house with lovely flowers. Fly flags from the towers. For Pepto's birthday, bake the most wonderful birthday cake. Place 12 beds in 2 straight lines. The last one will be Madeline's. "Welcome to London. The weather is fine, and exactly half past nine." "Good heavens," said Miss Clavel. "You brought no toy for this excellency little boy," said Madeline. "For everybody knows, of course, he always said craved a horse." In their little purses and Miss Clavel's bag, there wasn't enough money to buy the meanest nag. But in London, there's a place to get a retired horse to keep as a pet. And when they went to the place, they found a horse that was gentle, strong, and sound. "Some poor old bobbins are made into glue, but not this one. Look, he's good as new. This lovely, happy birthday, Pepto. Happy birthday to you. This lovely hearse belongs to you. Just then, Tara, Tara, a trumpet blew suddenly outside, and awfully he flew over the wall to take his place at head of the Queen's lifeguards, which he had always led before the Royal Society for the Protection of Horses had retired for him for her master's forces. Oh dear, they've gone. Oh, what a pity. Come, children, we'll find them in the city. Careful, girls, watch your feet. Look right before you cross the street. Oh, for a cup of tea and crumpets? Hark, hark, there goes the sound of the trumpets. These birds have seen all this before, but they are glad of it in core, and so are people on ship and shore. And now it's getting really grand. Here comes the mascot and his band. The people below are stout and loyal, and those on the balcony mostly loyal. The shore is over. It's getting dark in the city, in the park. Dinner is waiting. We must be on time. Now let's find Pepto and Madeline. Well, isn't it lovely? They're standing sentry right here at the White Hall entry. That is the power and the beauty. In England, everyone does his duty. Visiting is fun and really great. Let's celebrate a lovely day. Everyone had bed well fed. Everyone was in his bed. Only one was forgotten. He'd be on his feet all day long without anything to eat. In a cottage that was thatched, wearing horses that were patched, lived the gardener who loved flowers, especially in the morning hours, when their faces fresh with dew, smiled at him, "How do you do?" The gardener, who was never late, opened up the gate. The gardener who dropped his garden horse toes. There wasn't a daisy or a rose. All my work and all my care for naught. Oh, this is hard to bear. Where is my clearly carrots, my beans, and my peas? And why not, and not an apple on my apple trees? Everyone had to cry, not a single eye was dry. Oh, look, who is lying there with his feet up in the air? I feel his breath. He's not dead yet. Quick, Pepto, get the vet. The vet said, don't worry, he's only asleep. Let me get him. Help me get him on his face. As a diet, there's nothing worse than green apples and roses for an old horse. Dear Lady Miss Clavel, we beg your pardon. It seems our horse has eaten up your garden. A little sunshine, a little rain, and it all will be the same again. Pepto's mother said, quite so, quite so. Still, I'm afraid the horse must go. Then Madeline cried, I know what to do. Pepto, let us take care of him for you. Fasten your seat belts. In half an hour, you will see the Eiffel Tower. Madeline, where have you been? We've been to London to see the Queen. At last, sighed Madeline, we're able to sit down with being 13 at a table. They brushed his teeth and gave him bread. And covered him up and put him to bed. Good night, little girls. Thank the Lord you are well. And now go to sleep, said Miss Clavel. And she turned out the light and closed the door. There were 12 upstairs and below one more.